I'm here with Jonathan Scott, one of the organisers of Calentita. Jonathan, tell me about the preparations of this Calentita.
Well, I suppose we have been doing it for 7 years. This is the seventh year. So to a certain extent, things run a little bit more easily now. But starts months back, we invite different associations. We try and encourage charities, but different associations, sports associations, etc., to come on board and to actually get involved with running one of the stalls. They apply, they tell us what sort of food they're looking to serve. We try and make sure that it's distributed so that there's a nice balance, so we don't have, you know, like 20 montadito stalls. So that's the first round, I suppose. And of course, there's the logistics of bringing all the equipment in. But it's a team effort led by Owen Smith, very capably, who's been doing events in Gibraltar for many years. So I suppose it's second nature. There are always little problems, but you just have to overcome them.
And what's different about this year's Calentita? There are more stalls, different cuisines represented?
Yeah, there are. I suppose that's kind of what Calentita is looking to, sort of the message it's looking to communicate. That Gibraltar is a multicultural community. It has changed a lot over the years, and it continues to change because people continue to come to Gibraltar to work, or perhaps, you know, they come here on holiday and they fall in love with somebody or with a place and they settle here and they bring their own cultural backgrounds. So we do have new stalls this year. Hungarian is new. We've got the Jewish stalls for the first time because it's been moved to a Saturday to accommodate the Jewish community, which we're all really pleased about. There's also a long table area, which I hope you guys can see, which is in Marketplace, because some of the feedback that we've had in previous years is that it's so busy that people need somewhere to sit down, and the square is not the place for that. Marketplace is where they can do that.
What about your own preferences as regards local cuisine? Do you stick to local stuff like Calentita, or do you prefer the more exotic dishes?
Well, funnily enough, my mouth is a little bit sort of sticky at the moment because I've just had a really oily Calentita. Really, really tasty. I'm a big fan of Calentita, but I'm just generally a really greedy eater. So I'll be trying to get in as much as I can on the premise that, you know, stall inspection, how's everything going? Oh, I'll try one of them. Yeah.
Okay, Jonathan, have a good time and well done.
Thank you, and thank you for being here and supporting it.
I'm here with Tony of My Wines. Tony, what's your stall all about?
Well, we've got all the wines from the shop. We've got a Manzanilla, white wines, rosés, and we've joined up with Casa Cornwall, and we've got some octopus, grilled octopus, some tempura prawns, some meatballs with a surprise in the middle, and what else? And some chicken lollipops. So it's all good.
And I think you're matching the wines with the food, aren't you?
We're trying to, but it's all madness right now. Everyone's just asking for any wine, so we're just going with the flow.
And is it your first Calentita?
It is. I'm looking forward to the rest of the night and for the sun to go down a bit.
Thanks, Tony. Good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, Lionel, you're here in Calentita. How many times have you been here?
Probably since its inception. It was 7 years ago now. I've come every night and suffered the queues before, but now it seems to be... There seems to be more stalls, so I think it's going to be a great night for everybody.
And what does Calentita say about Gibraltar?
Well, the usual, no? The multicultural background to us, but it's great to see the fact that a lot of people get involved, that a lot of money goes to charity, and that people have a great time. I think we seem to only go out when there's organised things. I'd like Gibraltar to be out more all the time, be a real Mediterranean place.
And what's your favourite stall? Do you have one?
No, I'll try everything, I think, and then I'll need to sit down in one of the bars after standing around.
Okay, Lionel, thank you for talking to us. Have a good night.
Thank you. Enjoy.
Okay, I'm here at the Hungarian stall. What is Hungarian cuisine like?
Hungarian cuisine is absolutely delicious, very tasty, lot of herbs, a little bit spicy, lot of paprika. We have the specialty here today, the beef goulash, the stuffed cabbage, yes. The gundel pancake, that's a sweet, so it's really amazing. We should try to everybody recommended.
This is your first Calentita, isn't it?
Yes, we are very excited. That's why we're a little bit nervous.
We hope,
yes.
Not the last. Yes. We hope not the last one. Yes.
Yeah. And how long have you been cooking the goulash?
Six or seven hours, yes. And actually we was all day yesterday to preparing and cutting, so it's like we have to do it very slow. That's a secret. No more secret.
And what do you say what's bon appetit in Hungarian?
Jó étvágyat. Jó étvágyat.
Jó étvágyat.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.